So you open up your Google Search Console and found indexing issues like this, this, or this, and the tidy monster in you just wants to get this fixed, but you don't know how. Don't worry, we got you. In this video, we will explain these Canonical issues and let you know if you can do anything to fix them. Spoiler alert, you may not even need to do anything. Let's go. Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the one tool that provides you with easy-to-use SEO and AI tools, and this channel provides you with tips, tricks, and tutorials to help you grow your search traffic. So if you're new to us, consider subscribing. So Canonical issues in Google Search Console deal with duplicate content found on your site. But the thing is, Google doesn't index two or more pages with duplicate content but with different links. They choose one page out of the bunch to be indexed, and for the rest of the duplicated pages, they will be added in the Google Search Console with the Canonical issues. Now, duplicate content is not exactly a bad thing, especially if you have a legit reason for keeping them. Reasons like product variation pages. For example, this BBQ pit has four variations, and each of these product variation pages has its unique URL. Let me show you. Let's add the red BBQ pit to the cart. Let's do the same with yellow. And now let's view the cart. Over here, this is the link to the product variation page. Let's open them up in new tabs. And check this out. The red BBQ pit product variation page has this URL, and the yellow product variation page has a different URL, and this is the URL of the main product. Now, if you compare all the product pages, they have the same description and everything. It is just that the product image for each variation is different. So Google will view all these pages as duplicate, and you have to tell Google which is the main product page using the canonical attribute. Another reason is if you have a printer-friendly version of another page, that page might be flagged as a duplicate page as well. And also, if you have tracking links with session IDs like this, Google will try to crawl this link and discover it as a duplicate page. So these are the legit reasons you have duplicate pages on your site, but how should we deal with the canonical issues found on Google Search Console? So we are on the Google Search Console. Let's visit the Pages tab. And right below, you will see all the indexing issues on your site. These are the three canonical issues we'll be talking about. But we'll first talk about these two. The alternate page with proper canonical tag and the duplicate Google chose a different canonical than user because they are somewhat related. Let me run you through a scenario. Let's say that page A has this URL and page B has this URL. In your opinion, page A is the original or the main page. So it has this self-referencing canonical tag that points to its own URL. And then in your opinion, page B is a duplicate of page A. So it has a canonical tag that points to the URL of page A. So if Google agrees with you that page A is the original page and page B is the duplicate page, you will see the alternate page with proper canonical tag with page B's URL in it. If that is the case, nothing needs to be done. For example, let's visit this issue. Let's scroll down and let's say that I want to check out this page. Let's click on it and inspect the URL. Give it a while. Alright, if you scroll down, you will see the user declared canonical, which is the canonical URL defined by you for this particular page. And as for the Google selected canonical, it says that it is the same as the user declared canonical. So Google agrees with you with this canonical URL. If this is the case, nothing needs to be done. Now, the problem comes when Google does not agree with your declared canonical URL, and they tell you that they think page B should be the original or main page. In this case, you will see the duplicate Google chose different canonical than user with page A's URL in it. Something like this when you inspect the URL. So what should you do in such a case? Simple, just switch it. Have a canonical URL on page A that points to page B's URL, and have a self-referencing canonical URL for page B. Or simply add a noindex meta tag to page A. Alternatively, if you don't need page A anymore and you don't want your site visitors to have access to that page, then do a 301 redirect from page A to page B. That's the theory, but how is the canonical tag added to a page in practical terms? So a canonical tag will look like this. It is an SEO best practice to have canonical tag on every page of your website just to give clarity and affirm to the search engines on what pages you think are original or duplicate. For example, if you go to RankMath's homepage, right-click and view page source, Let's do a Control F or Command F and search for Canonical. You will see this link relation canonical tag that is self-referencing. It is not only on our site. If you go to WP Rocket, let's view its page source and search for canonical, and you will see the same line of code. So even if a page isn't a duplicate, the best practice is to have a line of code that defines the canonical URL with its own URL. Now let me show you another example where a page is duplicated and the link relation canonical URL points to another page. Now I have two identical pages side by side, but the only difference is that one starts with palette, with this URL here that starts with palette, while the other begins with electric. The rest of the contents are exactly the same. Now let's label this palette smoker page as the original or the main version, and this other page as the duplicate. I've already added a canonical link to this duplicate page that points to the main page. Let's view the page source for both these pages and search for canonical. Check this out. The canonical for the original or the main page points to its own URL, while the canonical URL of the duplicated page points to the original page URL. Now the question is, how do you add or edit these canonical URLs if you don't know HTML coding? RankMath has made it super easy for you to add canonical URLs. So earlier we have the palette smoker page as the original page and the electric smoker page as the duplicated page. To find where you can add canonical URLs, you need to visit the WordPress editor of the page. Let's do the same for the other page. And then let's click on the RankMath tab, then select the advanced settings. Right at the bottom, you will see the canonical URL. Let's do the same for the other page. Now, as you can see, for the original page, by default, without you adding anything to this field, RankMath will add a self-referencing URL in the canonical URL field. But as for the duplicate page, the canonical URL points to the original page. Now, if you face the duplicate Google chose different canonical than user issue, let's say that Google has decided that the electric smoker page should be the original instead, and your palette page is flagged with the issue, then all you need to do, if you want both pages to be available to your visitors, is to remove your defined canonical URL on the electric smoker page. And as soon as you have done that, a self-referencing canonical URL will be added. And then copy the URL of the electric smoker page and paste it in the canonical view of the palette smoker page. Simple and easy. Now this will tell Google that this is the original page and this is the duplicated version. Now what if you do not want this palette page to be available to your visitors? If that is the case, then you want to add a 301 redirect from the palette page to the electric page. Let me expand this page. Let's go back to the WordPress dashboard. To add a 301 redirect, let's hover over RankMath SEO and select the redirections module. Now, if you don't see this redirections module, then you want to click on dashboard. Make sure that the advanced mode is selected. Otherwise, you won't see the redirections module. And as you scroll down, you will need to toggle the redirections module on, and you will see the redirections menu item. Click on it, and here's where you manage all your redirections. Click on add new. Let me close this up again. For the source URL, which is the URL that needs to be redirected, for our case, it is this palette page. We want to copy the URL back to the tool and paste it here. And as for the destination URL, it will be the electric smoker page URL, since the palette page will be redirected to this electric smoker page. Let's copy the URL and paste it here. And then we want to select 301 permanent move. Let's keep the status as active and add the redirection. Now let me expand this back again and check this out. Take note of the URL as I refresh this page. Currently it is the palette smoker page URL. So if someone lands on this URL, as I refresh it, it becomes the URL of the electric smoker page. Now, it is really common to see paginated archive pages where the subpages closely resemble the main page in the duplicate Google chose different canonical than user issue. If that is the case, RankMath has some easy fix for you. Hover over RankMath SEO, select titles and meta, then you want to click on the miscellaneous pages. Right at the bottom, you will see the no index subpages, paginated pages, etc. You want to toggle them on and save changes. Simple and easy. So this is one error that is uncommon to Rank Math users. What this means is that Google has found, for example, this page as the duplicate page, but if you check the source code of the page, it is missing a canonical tag. In such a case, you are basically giving Google the power to decide what is the canonical URL. But since it is a duplicate page and you haven't defined it, that's why they will flag this page with the issue. As you know, Rank Math adds a self-referencing canonical URL to all pages of your site, so even if you have a URL with UTM tracking parameters, which is very common for this issue, Google tries to crawl the tracking URL because they are unique links, Rank Math users will rarely see this issue. So it is pretty simple and straightforward to solve canonical issues, and I hope this video is helpful. If it is, how about a thumbs up? And subscribe to us as we are all about helping you grow your search traffic. This is Jack from Rank Math. I'll see you in the next video.